river of living water in my soul, in my soul. There's a river of living water in my soul. To all who bless Jesus, he will give his living water so they shall live with a well springing up and overflowing to in his eternal life. There's a river of living water in my soul. Promise of new life to our living Lord. Bring good news to the lost. There is hope in Jesus Christ, who gives eternal life. There's a river of living water in my soul, in my soul. There's a
Morning. Morning. Welcome to Living Waters on this beautiful summer Sunday morning. We have a number of announcements as we have quite a lot going on. You'll see that Olivia is not here with us today. She is now ill, and so please keep her in your prayers. Hopefully, it's the summer of sickness apparently here at Living Waters. I don't know. So hopefully she'll be better soon, and we'll see her next week hopefully. In the meantime, big props to the band for pulling through. Yep. And Kermit, who's going to have a special role this morning because of this. You'll see later. You'll see. So props to Kermit. You'll understand in about 30 to 40 minutes. Okay. All right. A mystery. Okay. I do want to lift up our sermon series on rest this summer. Went well, even though I got sick. And the rest decorations are no more, but the word clouds are up on these back windows. Check those out. It's pretty cool. It's a compilation of all the answers we received from the various questions through the 4 weeks. And they also look really cool. So Becky Marshall did a great job putting those together, so please take time. Maybe it's right by the coffee. Get some coffee. Read about some rest. What a combo, right? Okay. Youth group will be on August 27th from 4 to 5:30. We will have a youth group meeting about the youth gathering at 3:30, so it's half hour before. Go for the meeting, stay for youth group, what a combo. If you have an announcement, by the way, start making your way up front. We're having a ministry fair after worship next week. That'll be our ministry teams. We'll have booths set up. They can answer all your questions about their ministries and how you can get involved. This is a way for people to find ways to connect and be involved in our various ministries and how we serve our community here at Living Waters. So please join us for that. It'll be a good time. Those who are going to be in confirmation at this year will meet with me and Michelle, the other leader, for confirmation briefly during that time, and then you can go right out to the fair. So don't worry, you won't miss the fair, confirmation families. But you should know this because I emailed you. Great. Okay. Announcement? Somebody? Come on up.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Chris Zybert, and I'm here to invite you to our Thursday morning Bible study. Have you ever wondered why the readings on Sunday go together? Pastor Zach can tell you. He's amazing. We have the best time.
Go on.
On Thursday mornings. It's almost like an history lesson, and you get to learn what Greek words mean, and there's a lot of excitement, and I really invite you to come and join us. We're, hybrid, Zoom and in person. We start at 9:45 and have to finish by 11, which sometimes is a stretch. But if you've ever, if you have some free time, come and check us out. It's really an interesting and exciting hour and 15 minutes. Thanks.
Thank you, Chris. Yes, we will be in person and online this week. I should be able to drive. So actually, I'm doing pretty good. I should announce at the beginning. Someone come walk up while I talk. But they increased my dose of my new medication on Friday because they were like, well, we put you on the schedule so you can recover from the side effects during the weekend. And I was like, well, I work on Sunday. And they said, oops. So, you know, same as the last couple weeks. If I run out, just carry on without me. Amy.
Good morning. I'm Amy. I am speaking for Gretchen, who is away this weekend. So kickoff Sunday is in 2 weeks, August 27th. It starts shortly after service. There are a couple of things that we're still in need of. Number one, anyone that feels comfortable face painting, it does not have to be an artistic person. I think most of us could probably do a snake, a butterfly, I don't know, a soccer ball. Like anybody that feels comfortable enough doing that. Anyone that thinks they can make something with balloons, she's really hoping to have somebody make balloon things as well. If for some reason you're like, okay, I can't do any of that, but I have some money to spare and you would like to donate to paying somebody to come in for that, please reach out to Pastor Zach or Gretchen. I think in the office manager email there's a link so you can go through that link as well. We also need juice boxes, any kind of snacks, any kind of water, all of that by next Sunday. If you could drop it off in the Sunday school classroom, I was just in there this morning, there's only been one drop off. So as many donations as possible. Anything extra will just kind of get stuck in a stash that will be used throughout the year. So no concerns about that. Just a reminder, even if you don't have littles going to Sunday school class, we do have an adult class. And if you are not interested in that, you should still stay. We have Taco Chicas going to be here, some fellowship, things of that nature. So please feel welcome to stay after church on August 27th. That's it.
Yeah, while you're up here, don't go far. We have a new worship chair for our worship team, Amy Cannon. That's it. I promise no speeches, but I was going to introduce you. Joel, good morning.
Good morning. Morning, Living Waters. I'm just here to remind the outreach committee and anyone who wants to come to the outreach team meeting tomorrow night, on Monday, we're meeting at the Fire Bar at the end of Alexandra. At 6:30. So, yes, in that direction right there. So, you're all welcome.
Great. Thank you, Joel. Marian Dahlke was not able to join us this morning, but she wanted me to remind you about the Chosen Study starting at September 6th at 7 p.m. Sign up is in the back. We're also doing the College Care Kits a couple weeks. And, oh, she was supposed to usher today. Can I get an usher to help Linda so Linda doesn't have to do it by herself? Thank you, Jenny. Great. Okay. You may notice if you go out into the back hallway there are vegetables. Those are from our garden, the community garden. We grow right here on the property. And then there are baked goods from our bake sale. The idea is you can take whatever vegetables and baked goods you would like, and if you would be willing to make a donation, the proceeds go go to Growing Hope Globally, which is a organization that helps do feeding ministries, create sustainable food structures around the world. So we like to support them. We've had them out a couple times, even this year. So if you could, again, you could get a nice balanced diet. You could get some vegetables. You can get some delicious baked goods, a little bit of both, you know? If you don't like veggies, go right for the baked goods. I won't judge. Anyway, so yeah, thank you for your support. Chris, you don't know about the parking lot raffle today? Because I'm not sure what to say. Okay, cool.
Good morning. So, we got the parking lot resealed and striped this past summer, thanks to donations from everyone. We got fully paid for, fully funded. Mm-hmm. And the long delayed raffle is today. So I've got door prizes on the table out there with a grand prize of a bucket that is for cleaning your car, taking care of your car. Plus, I have extra raffle tickets that were never claimed. I've got like close to 40 of them. So if you don't have a raffle ticket, I will give you one so you have one, and we'll do the raffle right after service.
Yep, great.
Cool.
Love that.
Out in the Norfolk, so.
There's a lot of prizes out there. I saw that. Looks good.
So come and see me for a raffle ticket. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you again for your support to make this project possible. Any other announcements this morning? I know, there's a lot going on. It's good. I love that Pastor Javier said a couple weeks ago while I was out that don't take for granted all the good things that are happening here. Lots of good things, and it's a good sign. Well, finally, during service today, we'll be having a blessing for back to school. If you are going back to school at any level, preschool, elementary, middle school, high school, college, master's degree, special education, whatever it is, if you work in education, teacher, staff, or however you identify as working in education, we want you to come up here. Now, this is the best part. It's the best part about these kind of things. This is like the Veterans Day blessing we do, too. I've been here long enough to know who you are. So, I will wait till you come up here, okay? All right. There's a fine line between a blessing and a hostage situation. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, so that'll be near the end of service, and I'll invite those folks up as well. All right. With that, let us stand as we are able as we begin worship together with the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who greets us in this and every season, whose word never fails and whose promise is sure.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins in the presence of God and our neighbors. Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned. We have hurt our community.
We have squandered your blessings.
We have hoarded your bounty. We have lacked courage to speak. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us mercy. God is a cup of cold water when we thirst. God offers boundless grace when we fail. Trust the gift of God's mercy. You are freed and forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater. God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater.
God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then who could stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then who could stand against? What could stand against? Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. God, God is healer, awesome in power.
And within us, and cause us to be afraid. Rescue your people from despair. Deliver your sons and daughters and children from fear, and preserve us in faith of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
The first reading today is Psalm 85, verses 8 through 13. You can find this reading on page 473 in the Bible under your chair. I will listen to what the Lord God is saying, for you speak peace to your faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to you. Truly, your salvation is very near to those who fear you, that glory may dwell in our land. Steadfast love and faithfulness have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Faithfulness shall spring up from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before the Lord and shall prepare for God a pathway. Our second reading this morning is from Romans chapter 10, verses 5 through 15. You can find this reading on page 921 in the Bible under your chair. Moses writes concerning the righteousness that comes from the law, that the person who does these things will live by them. But the righteousness that comes from faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven, that is, to bring Christ down, or who will descend into the abyss, that is, to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all and is generous to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But how are they to call on one in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in one of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone to proclaim him? And how are they to proclaim him unless they are sent. As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
We stand as you are able for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord according to Matthew, the 14th chapter. You can find this reading on page 796 in the Bible in the chair in front of you. This is Matthew 14, 22 through 33. Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side of the Sea of Galilee while he dismissed the crowds. After he dismissed the crowds, he went up to the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was alone there. But by this time, the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, and the wind was against them. And early in the morning, he came walking towards them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost!" And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and started walking on the water and came towards Jesus. When he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened and began to sink, and he cried out, "Lord, save me!" Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You have little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." This is the gospel of our Lord. Please be seated. I invite the kids up for the children's message this morning. Good morning. How y'all doing? Good? Okay. Who knows what this is? Pool noodle. And what does one do with a pool noodle? Okay, whack your friends. Okay. Not the answer I was looking for, but fair. What else? Why does this exist? So, have you ever been in deep water and you're not really comfortable in that deep water? You're not sure about swimming. Yeah? Yeah, so if you ever hold on to one of these, here, everyone grab it. All right, it's nice and light, right? But you can hold on to this and it'll keep you afloat. So, okay, let go, please, for a moment. Having one of these in the story this morning would have been kind of anticlimactic, right? Peter saying, "Lord, save me." Oh, wait, never mind, right? But, in a way, God gives us the pool noodle of faith that we, when we are in the hard times, sorry, hold on, yep, there we go. We all hold on to this faith and cling to it to help us get through the hard times. In fact, this church, in a way, is like the holy church of the pool noodle, right? That we are all here to support each other when we are struggling and the waves are high, all right? Will you pray with me this morning? I invite the congregation to join in as well. I'm going to hold this so no one gets whacked, okay. Dear God, thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for your faith and for this community to support us in the hard times. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, have a good week, gentlemen. So, we're going to try something new today. Yes, I always like trying something new here at Living Waters. I don't know if it was Songfest last week still resonating with me, but I felt myself being drawn to a song when studying this gospel text for the sermon this week, a hymn in particular called "What Wondrous Love Is This?" I asked Olivia, she said that we do not know this hymn. That's okay, you're going to hear it today. And the plan was that Olivia was going to sing during the sermon. So, batter up, Kermit's up next. So, Let's give some encouragement to Kermit here. Here we go. Yes. Yes. Here, I love that about us, Living Waters. Next person up. Okay. So, and this is going to be a lot better than me just reading the lyrics to you. We have the copyright to this, so we can sing it. So, if you want to follow along, you can find this in your hymnal on hymn, and this is not a joke, 666. Who says Lutherans don't have a good sense of humor, right? What wondrous love is this, is hymn 666. It was intentional, but I don't have enough time for that story.
Why do you think I'm doing it?
What?
Why do you think I'm doing it?
Yeah. So, Kermit will, we're going to sing a verse, preach a little bit, sing a verse, just see. So, Kermit will now sing verse 1 for us.
What wondrous love is this, oh my soul, oh my soul? What wondrous love is this, oh my soul? What wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul? For my soul to hear the dreadful curse for my soul.
Beautiful. And yes, of course, you can sing along if you wish, of course. Now, you may have noticed this gospel reading this morning, the first word is, did anyone catch it? Immediately. Immediately. Curious minds might ask, what came before this passage that immediately Jesus and the disciples get on a boat? I'll save you the trouble of flipping back. We had the feeding of the 5,000 men plus women and children. So the 5,000 plus, as I like to call it. We actually use this text, this gospel text today, in our closing worship for the mission trip, where we talked about having this amazing, faith-nourishing experience that was our week in Milwaukee, where we saw God in so many powerful ways, but how it can feel jarring when we return to our normal lives. Immediately, everything goes back to normal. Even though we have witnessed this great moment just right before. Perhaps God and faith are not easy to see as they were in a week in Milwaukee in July. And to a lesser degree, I find this to be true with all of us, that faith and all this talking of God is easiest on Sunday morning. But when we try to live out our faith in our normal lives, God can feel more elusive sometimes. And in our busyness, faith can be reserved for a mealtime or bedtime prayer. There's a reason I try to give us a takeaway from our time in Scripture every Sunday. Putting our beliefs into practice is key to our formation of our very lives. But it can be hard amongst all the pressures of everyday normal life. Don't believe me? Look at this gospel passage where the disciples have come immediately from the feeding of the 5,000 plus. This incredible miracle. And here they are going back to normal life along with each other and Jesus. They're traveling yet again. And yet when they see Jesus walking on the water, they don't recognize him, saying, "It's a ghost." Even though they had just witnessed God powerfully in their lives just moments ago, so quickly we fail to see God in action in our lives immediately again. We even begin to question the wondrous love of God. We begin to focus on our shortcomings and imperfections instead of the unconditional love that God has for us. Quickly, we let the world determine our worth for us, even though God has already gracefully redeemed us fully and calls us good. God's wondrous love is so opposite from so much that we experience in the world that we begin to wonder how real God's love really can be and how it can truly impact our lives Monday through Saturday. Verse 2, please.
down, sinking down, sinking down. When I was sinking down, sinking down. When I was sinking down, beneath God's righteous frown, Christ laid aside his crown for my soul, for my soul. Christ laid aside his crown for my soul.
Peter gets a lot of, as St. Paul writes in Philippians, scubala for this passage. You can look up that later what that means. But actually, I admire Peter this morning. He's doing what we're all trying to do. Figuring out how to live out this precious faith in our lives. We shouldn't be denigrating the courageous living out of our faith. And yet so often, I don't know about you, but so often I have heard this passage preached in this way, that Peter doesn't have enough faith. Therefore, he sinks. Oh, yes, he's quite literally sinking down, sinking down. Where the emphasis on what Jesus is saying is often this tone of disgust. Peter, you of little faith, why did you doubt? It's accusatory, shaming. But that doesn't add up to our God of wondrous love, does it? A God of grace, freely given. First off, I want to point out, I feel like it, for Peter's sake, and I'm not the biggest Peter fan, but I got to stay up for him here. He's only out on the water because Jesus commanded him to do so. Second, Peter only starts to sink when he becomes afraid. When the pressures of the world around him become too much, he shouts out, "Lord, save me." I'm sorry, last week we heard from the Psalms, that praise in a real relationship is good, that we should have this with God. But here, we're led to believe Jesus is shaming Peter for this? No. Notice our key word shows up again. Immediately. Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You have little faith. Why did you doubt?" This is not a moment of shameful judgment. It is a moment of merciful concern, of grace. Jesus is surprised that Peter doubted, for Jesus knows Peter. He believes in Peter. He called Peter. He loves Peter. They've been through so much together. They've just fed over 5,000 people. Now, this is not a shaming teacher. This is a God immediately caring for Peter out of a wondrous love. This is God building Peter back up, asking him why he's struggling, even though he has a real relationship with God. Peter, look at you. You just walked on water. You're capable of so much. Why do you doubt yourself? Have some faith. You got this. When we are sinking down, and life just seems to be too overwhelming for us, we often think that God is looking down at us, as the hymn states, with that righteous frown. And how quick we are to forget that Christ laid aside his crown for our soul. We forget that when we call out to God, God reaches out to us immediately. Unconditionally. Even if sometimes we have trouble seeing it in our normal lives, we forget that God is love. As Luther famously preached, terrible, unforgiving, that is how I saw God. Punishing us in this life and the next. Sentencing sinners to burn in hell for all eternity. But I was wrong. Those who see God as angry do not see God rightly. He continues, if we truly believe that Christ is our Savior, then we have a God of love. God must be mercy.
Verse 3, please.
To God and to the Lamb I will sing, I will sing. To God and to the Lamb I will sing. To God and to the Lamb, who is the great I Am. While millions join the theme, I will sing, I will sing. While millions join the theme, I will sing.
God is caring and loving. And I think what so often gets understated, God is understanding. God in Jesus Christ lived a human life. God knows our struggles firsthand. God knows how hard life can be. This is why God reaches out to us in love immediately. It's also why our God calls us to worship as a community every week, to join together and to remember who God is, to remember the power of love and justice, mercy, truth, and faith, these gifts that we've been given that make our normal lives better. To be refilled this day for the challenges of Monday through Saturday ahead. God wants us to remember those faith moments, those high peaks where we did see God so clearly and powerfully in our life. Our modern day feedings of the 5,000, our moments of walking on water. God wants us, just like Peter, to learn and grow from them. Everything that we have done in those moments, everything that we have felt, everything that we have learned about ourselves, these are all gifts from God to help us live the rest of our lives fully. God has already taken care of the next life. In this one, God wants us to try living in faith out. Faith is not just drifting through life, hoping God will protect us from the bad things that can happen. No, faith is having the courage to put what you believe into practice, even if it might not go well. You might be sinking down. You will, need God's help. But here today, God is ready to offer that help immediately. Faith is not drifting. Often faith is sinking and swimming over and over again. But the good news for us, no matter how many times we sink down, God is always there to pull us back up, to help us try it again. We are never in this alone. We are never beyond God's love. People of God, join the millions who are far from perfect, but try their best to live out their faith every day, who speak openly with God, even in the times when they are most vulnerable. Join the millions who have the courage to try something new, to be bad at something before we can be good at it. We take that leap of faith in a normal life, trusting in the wondrous love of God and of the Lamb. You are not in this alone. You have God immediately ready to help. And you have this church community, part of the millions who trust in Christ our Lord, who try our best to live out what we believe every day. The final verse, please.
And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, sing God's love for me.
focuses on is sort of the my favorite verse of this hymn. Here in this song, we've gone from questioning and proclaiming the wondrous love of God to admitting our vulnerabilities in the times where we sink down, to trusting God and the community of faith. And here we end. We end with a powerful statement of faith. That when this life is over, we will be with God and our loved ones past forever. And if the love of God in this life wasn't enough to celebrate, three verses of that. God has overcome this world. Death itself has been defeated forever. This promise is forever. For now, that promise is proclaimed in this place every Sunday morning. That promise encourages us to go back out into the world, into our normal lives, Monday through Saturday, living with that bold faith. That no matter what challenges come, we know a living God has won. Even if something is too much for us right now, it'll never be too much for God. The God who conquered death, the God who will see us through. This week, when you are sinking down, do not be ashamed. As Jesus says this morning, do not be afraid. Live knowing that God will catch you immediately. Call upon your God. Engage in that real relationship. Even if it feels strange or new at first, don't worry. Out of grace and love, God will keep coming back. God will never give up on you. No matter how many times you sink, Peter is the rock after all. In your normal life, where so much challenges us, makes us question and doubt ourselves, makes us feel bad about who we are, live knowing you always have the wondrous love of Jesus Christ. When the world tears you down, God is building you back up. Where someone does not accept who you are, God always will. God created you and still to this day and always loves you fully and is actively involved in your life, actively involved in your learning and your growing from your moments of failure, but also in the moments when you're raised up and redeemed again. God celebrates who you are and who you will become. God is faithful in this life and the next. Friends, dare this week. Dare this week to live out that faith. Dare to live knowing what we believe. Walk on the waters, even if you sink. Have the confidence and trust that God will raise you up again. Life is too short to simply drift along through our days. It's time to sink and swim. Claim the life that God has given you. Live fully into every blessing and trial ahead. You are never alone. You have God. We have each other. Indeed, today in all of these gifts, encouraging immediate rescuing and blessings, we powerfully see a God of wondrous love. Lord, help us. Help us to live this faith all the week long. Amen. Thank you.
too small. I never feared you at all, no. If you touched my face, would I know you? Looked into my eyes, could I behold you?
Please stand as you're able. And join me in confessing our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, Son of the Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended to the dead. The third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Confident that the Church, that God receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. God of grace and faith, your faithfulness is never ending and your righteousness becomes ours through Christ Jesus. Send the church to proclaim the gospel both near and far, in church buildings and on street corners, in person and through digital means. Hear us, O God. God of sky and sea, the plants, animals, mountains, and plains proclaim your glory. Prosper the work of ecologists as they teach us new ways to care for your environment. Bring relief to areas recovering from natural disasters. Hear us, O God. God of peace and justice, you call us to live as your beloved community throughout the world. Instill in local, regional, national, and global political and civic leaders a desire to work for the well-being of all your people. Hear us, O God. God of care and compassion, you bring assurance when we are afraid. Bring calm to any who are anxious or fearful. Bless the work of therapists, nurses, and all other healthcare providers. Comfort those who grieve and soothe any who are sick. Today we lift up prayers, especially out loud in the silence of our hearts or at home in the comments section. Hear us, O God. God of wonder, you accompany us in both joys and sorrows. We pray for the children and teachers preparing for a new school year. Make your presence known in our work and play, in our lively conversation, and in our quiet rest. Hear us, O God. God of new life, you send people to renew both church and society. We give you thanks for the lives of the faithful service as examples of following your call. Hear us, O God. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray. In the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share a sign of that peace. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right,
holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. Deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. All people are called to Christ's table. Come and eat what is good. All are welcome.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. All right, at this time, back to school blessing. Students, teachers, educators, administrators, anyone who is education adjacent, come on down. There's going to be a lot of us, so get comfortable with each other. Come on. Face that way. Face that way. Come on. Come on. Come on. All right, I got to make sure no one else is holding out here. Okay. All right. So you can see, we have a lot of people who are blessing our community in this way. So I need everyone to put their right hand up. So you people are going to bless these people. Okay. And these people, we're going to bless people at home who couldn't make it today who are also educators. So kind of put the camera. Yeah, there we go. Or you can go towards each other, too, if you really want it to look kind of chaotic and cool. All right, here we go. Let us pray. God, today we pray for students, teachers, and all in education at the beginning of the school year. Give them open minds and hearts to learn and experience more fully the majesty of the world you've created. When they are nervous, remind them of your love. When they are frustrated, give them peace and rest. Enable them to grow in knowledge and wisdom during the school year and all the days of their lives. Bless teachers, school staff, students, and their families, and all who are involved in education in any way. We bless them that this year will serve them well. In the name of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Okay, now, don't go anywhere. Now we have the normal blessing. So you're going to help me with that too, people up here. So now you're going to return the blessing, if you will. So put your hand up. Come on. Very good. Very good. The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest seed, bless, keep, and sustain you now and to the end of the age. Amen. Now you can return to your seats and sing a song. Thank you.
I want to sing a song for you, Lord, for you. I want to sing a song. I want to give my voice to you. Listen to the angels sing along the song of your faithfulness, song of your praise. Lord, your love and kindness. Thank you.
Schenkenfelder is going to be handing out raffle tickets for those who need some. You do not need to be present to win, okay? So if you have to run, you can still grab a ticket. Okay. Go in peace. Share in the harvest.
You are God in heaven, and here am I on earth. So I'll let my words be few. Jesus, I am so in love with you.